Good afternoon. This is Ken Earle with EZkem. Today we're continuing in the series of cadmium coils, and I just want to reemphasize where we left off. When you first open a cadmium coil and use it for the first time, you want to just leave cupric sulfate in it for a few minutes. Basically just flush it through, use it, and come back. Once you've used it a few times and you're comfortable, you can go ahead and flush with water initially, never going to the bottom, always leaving it so no air comes in there. And then you're going to hit it with HCl, and I'm not actually using acid, so that's why I don't have gloves. You probably want to use gloves when you do this. You always want to stop the syringe before it gets to the bottom. And then you want to come in with cupric sulfate, and you want to go ahead and leave it in there for a few minutes. This will really help solidify the bond between copper and cadmium. Because remember, when you're reducing nitrate to nitrite using a cadmium coil, it's actually the copper sulfate that is reducing nitrate to nitrite. So you want to keep a good bond between the cadmium and the copper sulfate. Oxygen will strip cadmium from the copper, from the cadmium. High acid will do the same. So if you have samples that have a lot of acid in them, you need to bring them either closer to neutral or use a stronger buffer. And also metals can strip the copper from the cadmium. Now, when you're finished, at the end of the day, we recommend that you flush with DI water. Just come in with DI water one or two times, and you don't want to leave bridge in there overnight for sure, because that can cause it to plaque up. In general, you don't want to leave any surfactant in the coil when you're running. Fill it with DI water, neutral, it is, and then just let that sit there. Everybody's a little different. I often find that if you had it charged and ready to go, it should be good just like this, but some people will go ahead and quickly charge it before each run. And it should be good. The main problem is leaving bridge or buffer in the cadmium coil, so that it plaques out and covers all of the copper and it's unable to reduce nitrate to nitrite. So this has been our second series in the series of cadmium coils. Be sure and check back in for the next series talking about different contaminations and problems that can happen. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.